हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर सी एस रघुवंशी, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग FET रामा यूनिवर्सिटी उत्तर प्रदेश कानपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू हैव वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस, दैट इज डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम DBMS। सो बिफोर गोइंग इन डेप्थ अबाउट दिस सब्जेक्ट, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू how data is important to the computer science student, not only to the computer science student, for everyone who are working over the internet, who are using the computers, who are using the mobiles, and who are using the technology in their day-to-day life. So you must understand there are more than four subjects are designed around the term data in computer science. First, DBMS, that is database management system. Second one is data structure. Next one is data mining, next data mine warehousing, and most important and advanced subject that is bombarding in our daily life is data science and data analytics. So you can easily realize the importance of the data, okay? How data is important, that more than five subjects are designed around the term data. So very first, I would like to brief you about the basic of the database management system, or you can understand the, I would like to tell you the introduction of this subject. So this subject is designed around the two basic terms. First one is, you can see, the database. And next one is management system. So I tell you what is database. Database is simply a repository of the data. Means it provide a mean to store the data. Nothing else. It is not facilitating anything to the end user. But if we deal with the management system, means we have something that support, that provide a lot of facility to the end user, so the end user can access the information of their desire. Suppose I want to access the information, how many students are enrolled in BTech Computer Science. If we have a database, so it is possible by just writing a command or by just clicking on the buttons, we can see the desired information on our screen. So these type of facilities we are providing through the management system. So the database management system is a collection of two things. First one is database, second one is management system. So database is providing only the mean to store the data. It does not provide any facilities, any support to the end user, so he or she can access the desired information. For retrieving the desired information, we have a management system with the database. So management system provide a number of tools, a number of things, number of queries to retrieve the information from the database. Suppose we have a database of students in a university, and we want to access the information, how many students are enrolled in BTech Computer Science in session 2021. So it is very easy to access such kind of information by using the management system that is deeply integrated with the database. So this is a very basic introduction of the subject, the DBMS. A DBMS is simply a collection of data and a management system, and having a number of programs to access that information from the database. So we can easily understand the database is simply a collection of data, and a number of software programs are available in the database, in the system, to access the information. Now, I'm coming on the next thing, that is, what are the prerequisites? What are the prerequisites to learn this subject, to understand this subject? So in my point of view, student must have basic understanding of programming, okay, how to write a program, or a student must have basic understanding of database applications. What do you mean by database application? The application, or you can understand the software program that are having database in background. So this type of application having database in background on a server is called database application. So for understanding this subject, for getting expertise in the subject, a student must have basic knowledge of programming, or I think a student must have enough knowledge or enough practical knowledge of C or C++ and the file handling. What is file handling? That we will discuss in later in this series. So the prerequisite of this subject is only having good knowledge or sufficient knowledge of programming. This is sufficient. Now we will discuss about the course outcomes and learning outcome. Okay, today we are discussing about the database management system. Some of the students may ask, sir, why should I learn this subject? Why should I getting expertise in this subject? So I'm going to tell you, if you are interested in database management system or you are having this subject in your BTech, so after completing this subject, you will be able to understand what is basic of database. What is the database and what is the database management system and what are the softwares or available in the market to handle the database of a particular organization. For example, Oracle, SQL Server, Sybase, DBase. So number of softwares are available in market, so you can handle your database or database of your particular organization. So after completing this subject, student will be able to understand what is database and what should I do to maintain a database of my company, of my organization, or of my university also. The next thing that student will be able to do after completing this subject is the student will be able to design a database of a particular organization. Yeah, it is very much practical. Oh, I know database, I know each and everything about the database. I am not able to make the database of a particular organization. The reason is that you are not having the practical exposure of making the database of a particular organization. But I guarantee if you are attending my classes, you will be able to design a database of any organization or any companies. The second thing, the student will be able to design a ER diagram. ER diagram means what? Entity relationship diagram. About this we will discuss later, but the student will be able to design a ER diagram and will be able to transform this ER diagram into a database. Into a database, no matter in which software you are making your database, but a student will be able to make a database from the ER diagram. Next, the next thing is that the student will be able to understand the basic concept of normalization. So student should ask me, sir, what is normalization? These things we will discuss later, but a student will be able to make to normalize the database. Normalize means, so a student will be able to make a database that act normal in any conditions. Okay, that don't have many anomalies. So we will discuss this term anomaly also later. So the next thing, the student will be able to understand the concept of concurrent transactions and also having the knowledge of the problems that may occur during the concurrent transaction and will be able to understand and sort out the problem of concurrent transaction. So these are the basic learning outcome that will student gain after completing this subject. So student, after discussing about the prerequisite of the subject, learning outcome of the subject, and after having the basic understanding of the subject, we should have basic understanding and we should very clear about the data information, database, and then we will come finally on the database management system. Yeah, I understand. What we should very much clear about the data. What is data? So student, anyone can tell me what is data? Yeah, data is a simply a raw material, unstructured fact, or maybe image that do not reveal any information. Means data is something that have no meaning. Suppose I am writing here 25, okay, then RAM, okay. So 25 is a data and I am saying it is not representing any information. It is not revealing any information. Means the value having no meaning is called data. Great. I am saying data having no meaning or values, figures, facts having no meaning, having no values representing the data. Great. So some of the students may ask, sir, what you are saying? 25 is representing nothing? Okay, yes, 25 is representing nothing. It does not have any value. It does not have any meaning. But a student is saying, sir, 25 is a number. I understand, dear, 25 is a number, but what it is representing? It may represent your age, great. It may represent the number of students present in my class. It may represent the price of Colgate 100 grams. But I am not sure what 25 is representing here. The next thing, RAM. Yes, Ram is also representing nothing. Ram does not have any meaning. Maybe Ram is the name of my father. Maybe Ram is the name of my students. Maybe Ram is the name of Lord. It may anything, but I am not sure what it is representing here. So you can easily understand data is something that having no meanings. Okay? Now come to the next thing. What is information? Now, yeah, this question is very important. So information means data having meaning is called information. What is the beautiful definition of the information? Data having meaning, data representing meaning is called information. What is this? Date, value, fact, figure, image representing no meaning is called data. If these are representing the meaning, it's called information. So what is the difference between data and information, sir? And when will I say this is the info, 25 is the information and 25 is the data? Yeah, I am telling you. Sir, if I am writing here only 25, means it is representing nothing. So it is categorized as a data. If I am saying I am 25 year old, this is not true, but it is representing the age of Dr. Raghuvanshi. So now it becomes information. If data is ready to represent something, if data is ready to reveal some information, some meaningful, then we say it is information. Suppose I am writing, Ram is a student of BTech Computer Science and His age is 25 years. Okay? Now, Ram and 25, both becomes the information because both are representing the information. Both are revealing something that is meaningful. Because now I am very much clear that Ram is a student who is studying in BTech Computer Science and his age is 25. So 25 and Ram both becomes the information now because both are representing something that is meaningful. So student, you must ask, sir, can I transform data into information? Is it possible to me for transforming data into information? Yes, it is possible because we need some process to apply over the data, and after applying process over the data, it may becomes information. Suppose I have a data that is Ram and next one is 25, and I have applied some process P, and and the output of the process is Ram is a student of BTech Computer Science and his age is 25. Now I can say after applying any process over the data may transform into a information. So there is no big difference between the data and information. The difference in between is only the meanings. If something having no meaning, if you are not in position to say something about the facts that you are saying, okay, this fact is considered as a data. If I am in position to say something about the fact, figure, and something, anything, so you can say now it is a information. Now these facts are information, because I have 25, but I am not in position to say anything about the 25, so 25 will consider as a data. Or if I am saying, sir, 25 is the strength of my class, so now 25 is considered as a information. So now, student, you should very clear about the concept of data and information. Now I think we are in great position. We are in position to understand the database management system, or we can say only database. So now the question is, database is a collection of data. Good. Data is simply a things having no meaning, but database is a collection of things having no meaning. Now, come to the next point, that is database management system. Now, data is something having no meaning. Database is a collection of those things having no meaning. But database management system, the database management system is a collection of data as well as collection of programs, collection of process that can transform data into a information. Now it is very much clear to you, database management system is simply a collection of data plus having number of process, number of programs that can transform your data into an information. So this is a very simple definition of database management system. If someone asks you about the database management system, you should say database is a collection of fact, figure, and images. And database management system, is one step ahead of the database, having a number of program or number of process to transform these data into information. Student, you must be very clear, whatever we are storing in a computer is our data. But whatever you are fetching from the computer, whatever you are retrieving from the computer, or whatever you are seeing over the screen of the computer is our information. This should be very clear, ki whatever is storing in a data in a computer is data, and whatever you are seeing over the screen is an information. So for today's class, this is my presentation about the database management system. In the next class, we will discuss in detail about the file processing system, limitation of the file processing system, and the advantage of database management system. And we will also elaborate something commercial database management softwares available in the market, like Oracle, SQL Server, Sybase, DBase, and many more are available in the market. We will discuss in our next class. Thank you. Thank you very much.